Hey pedalers, welcome back to another video. Today we're going to be taking a first look and unboxing of my new Shimano M9100 XTR pedals that I recently got for my gravel bike. So without further ado, let's get right into this video. So these are my new Shimano XTR M9100 pedals, and these were recently purchased for $179 USD or $239 Canadian. So it is quite expensive, but this is the cream of the crop in terms of quality that Shimano has to offer for cyclocross and gravel pedals. So I was really excited to get these because I do have a gravel bike that I've been just itching to ride all winter. It's just been sitting in my room. And finally, I got around to purchasing the pedals to put on it and do some long gravel rides. So let's open it up and see what you get in terms of what you get in these pedals. So XTR, if you guys are not familiar, are Shimano's top tier. I've had the XT pedals before. So this is the right and this is the left. So we will open this up and see it. But if you guys haven't seen it, this is what the XTR pedal looks like. We'll take this off so you can see the logo. I like how the pedal doesn't have XTR here like the XT pedals have. So this is the standard 55 millimeter axle length. So just standard, really nice, super good quality in terms of material. And I'll give you guys some specs in terms of why I went for the XTRs instead of the XT pedals. So the reason why I went for the XTR pedals instead of the XT pedals, which I've ridden in the past and actually raced on, is because the XTR pedals have a wider platform, which is gonna be great for long rides, especially long gravel rides. And I think overall, just power transfer. Now, I don't know how accurate that is. I'm gonna have to test it. I do remember how it felt riding on XT pedals. But then again, I just wanted something that was going to be super high quality that I knew was going to perform and be a top performer for gravel riding. And especially when I start racing, if racing comes back for cyclocross this upcoming season. It's slightly more narrower compared to the XT pedals and it has a flatter stack height. Now, those things I think are just somewhat marginal. Now, if you're looking for top tier performance or marginal gains, or you're very, very into racing and very in tune with your fit or just your riding, then those things can probably be felt. But for me, I would say the majority of it, you can't really feel it. Now, I don't know how much that makes a big difference in terms of day-to-day riding, but I do know for racing, it can get quite specific for top racers, which these pedals are designed for. But the reason why, yet again, I went for these pedals instead of XTs, which I had in the past, was just from what I've read and watched, these pedals perform such more reliable when compared to the XT pedals, and they are actually a little bit lighter. So the XT pedals weigh 340 grams for the pair, and these ones actually weigh 314 grams for the pair, which I'm not a weight weenie, but you know, every gram counts, and I just wanted a top tier performer in terms of pedals. So I'm very happy. These pedals should last a long time. I'll give you guys an update in terms of bearings also after I get some long rides on it. And now we will put these on the bike and I will show you guys what it looks like, and I'll show you guys how to install these too. I almost forgot, it does come with the mounting cleats for your mountain bike shoe or cyclocross shoe, so don't forget that, but I already have it installed on my shoes, so I don't have to worry about these. So the next step is to put the pedals onto the crank, and we're just going to have to put a little bit of grease on the pedal, just to make sure it's coated properly. You don't have to put too much, and I will suggest using your fingers first rather than the Allen key. Just because you don't want to, you know, strip it or install it improperly. So now we just slowly start tightening it. And now you can see that it is going in without a problem. And you want to take this time, just do it really nicely. Because if you do it improperly, then you can mess up the whole crank. And we don't want that problem because cranks are expensive. So we will tighten it after with the torque. Just because it's 10 newton meters that we have to torque it down to. And then I will install on the other side, the other pedal. So this is probably my favorite part when you hear the click. So you'll hear it right there. That was the click. And we'll do the same thing on the other side. And then we're basically done in terms of the installation. And I will show you guys the clip in with my shoes. And they're pretty special shoes, which I will do a review on later. So you guys will be shocked if you guys haven't seen this. So let's click the other side and then get outside. The second click that everyone is waiting for. And right there, you can see we both have both pedals ready to go and time to go outside. So that is what the pedals look like on the bike. I love how it doesn't say XTR here and you only see it on this side. And now I'm gonna show you guys what it looks like outside, but I wanted to show you guys the shoe. So it kind of looks like a normal running shoe.
and this was only available in Germany. The color here in North America, they only had navy blue, but right here, you guys are gonna be blown away. So it looks like a normal trainer or running shoe, whatever you guys call it, where you're from. But then, boom, we got cleats on the underside, and you can actually put a cover on top if you guys want to remove this and just use it as a normal shoe. But this was actually amazing. I used it for commuting, and because I didn't really have a dedicated gravel bike or cyclocross bike, I didn't get that much use on it. But now I'm gonna be using this all the time when I'm doing just commute rides or just leisure rides. It's gonna be super nice and something that's more casual. You don't have to have a full-on mountain bike shoe or cycling kit. So I love these, and I'll show you what it looks like outside clipping into the pedals for the first time.
So as you guys can see, I'm wearing the shoes right now, and time to clip in on the bike. And right there, that's the first clip in, and then we got the second. And you can see it looks really nice. And I love these. They feel so light on the bike. So these pedals so far, so good. These shoes obviously aren't made for cyclocross. These are made for commuting.
So in terms of the clicking in, the pedals feel amazing. They feel light, they feel sturdy. A full review once I do some long gravel rides are gonna be done on my channel, so stay tuned for that. But I'm really, you know, impressed with the overall quality of build just right now. And until the next one, keep on pedaling. Thank you.